And now some energy experts have suggested that it will be irrelevant to talk about the power sector debts at a time the president has announced relief measures in the sector. It's a report by Godfrey Tanam.
The major challenges faced by the energy sector in Ghana are attributed to electricity tariffs that do not cover the cost of non-portfolio power purchase agreements, low collection, high technical and commercial losses, absence of proper system for measuring and paying for the cost of power for street lighting. In the wake of the COVID-19 pandemic, government has instituted some measures to cushion the living conditions of citizens. The recent one announced by the president is the absorption of electricity bills by government for the next 3 months.
That is free electricity for persons who consume 0 to 50 kilowatt hours a month for this period. In addition, for all other consumers, residential and commercial, government will absorb 50% of your electricity bill for this period.
This has sparked some joy among Ghanaians, hoping that they will be a little relieved in these trying times. Energy expert Kojo Poku is of the view Ghanaians should accept the consequences of the directives after the pandemic.
Government is going to spend something like a billion Ghana cedis in this gesture. That is a hole in the government coffers. Wherever government takes that money from, we have to pay that money back down the line. Government doesn't do freebies.
He is of the view it is not the right time to talk about the debts already incurred.
This is not the time to start talking about the problems in the energy sector.
Right.
The energy sector indebtedness to ECG, to VRA, to Ghana Gas, to ANI exists.
Energy economist and adjunct lecturer at Ghana Technology University College, GTUC, Dr. Riverson Opon, views the president's directive as laudable, indicating that Ghana's economy is crowded with small and medium-scale enterprises which are struggling in these difficult times.
Looking at the fact that majority of Ghanaians are into businesses, be it small-scale or medium-scale, majority living from hand to mouth, for that matter, the COVID-19 has well affected importation of goods from China and Europe due to the lockdown, hence collapsing several businesses. I therefore see this as a social sustenance to Ghanaians and must be appreciated.
But he argues that considering the debt in the energy sector, one may be tempted to discourage the implementation of the directives.
Objectively looking at the debt in the energy sector, I will of course object to this decision, knowing well that this would incur additional debt. In November last year, GRIDCO withdrew emergency service over debt, expressing great concern about debt owned by the ECG, Valco, and the NETCO.